Hello students, today we'll start a new poem called Good Books. What is the name of the poem? Good Books. The previous lesson, what was it? The girl who hated the books. But now the poem is regarding about good books. Then later on in that lesson you came to know that how she felt the importance of books, how important a book are, and then what are the things she learned from that. Everything you came to know in the previous lesson. So in this, good books means what you are going to learn in this poem. Okay, this is the main objective, this is the main moral of the poem. What is the importance of good books and how you should keep the books? Good books are friendly things to own. If you are busy, they will wait. So what is the meaning of this? So there is no such thing, oh, this is a regarding your studies or academics, whatever, this is good book, this is bad book, this is not a good subject, no, nothing is there. Everything is equal. Okay, so books means you have to keep, you have to preserve it very neatly, and you see that the pages are kept neatly, whatever it is. If you adapt all these habits in your young age, you the same thing you'll be following in the when you grow big also. Okay, the same thing you will follow, and you will see that your books are kept neatly. It even you will feel comfortable. Suppose if you want to open the books and see, this book is neat, I have to keep it neat. In case if the book's pages are shattered here and there, will you feel interested to learn? No. So this is the advice what we are giving is, keep your books neatly, whichever it is. Okay, good books are friendly things to own. It is very very friendly to you. If you are busy, they will wait. They will not call you on the phone or wake you if the hour is late. So the meaning of this is, do they come and call you over the phone or the book, see, come on, take me and read me? No, it will not tell. So, and one more thing is, or wake you if the hour is late. Suppose if the time is beyond the thing, suppose if you are getting ready somewhere and the time is gone, or is it going to tell you the hour is late, come on, take me the books? No, nothing it will tell. They stand together row by row. So how you arrange the books are all, whether it may be vertically or horizontally, you should keep your books very very neatly also. In this, they are standing together row by row, just they are arranging the books row by row. Upon the low shelf or the high shelf, there will be different shelves, isn't it? Shelves will be the bookshelves. Book shelf. How do you arrange the books? You arrange it neatly in an order. It may be either the lower shelf or higher shelf. But if you are lonely, this you know, you have a friend or two nearby. Suppose if you feel very very lonely, if nobody is there, if you feel very alone, if you are only one in the home, what you do? You take one book and read. You will be refreshed. You feel so comfortable. Oh, that I'm going to read a book. That is why if you cultivate this kind of habit, it is very very useful. You gain so much of knowledge also. The friendship of books is real. So this is not going to be a fake. Okay, it will be every time the real one, because you are gaining knowledge from this. Books are providing good knowledge. It may be either good story books, or it may be either your school books, whatever it is. What you are gaining by reading it, you are gaining good knowledge also. They are never noisy when you are still. Children, human beings, what you do? If you are sitting quietly, you don't sit quietly and you do all kind of noisy things and all. But do you see books somewhere making noise like this and that? No, they are never noisy when you are still. Still means it's not moving, it is stable in one place. They won't disturb you at your meal. So suppose if you are having any meals or anything, do they come and sit next to you and disturb you? No, they don't disturb. They comfort you when you are ill. When you are ill means when you are not feeling well. What happens if you are feeling very very feverish or ill, unhealthy or anything? What you just take one book, you relax, and if you are tired also, you take one book and read. You feel so refreshed. Okay, so they will comfort. Comfort means make you feel better. What it is? Comfort. C-O-M FORT, comfort, feel better. They help you pass the time away. Pass the time away means spend time. Or by reading the books, you are spending some valuable time also. You are not wasting time. You are spending some valuable time. They'll give you advice if you need. Suppose if you read any books regarding this, you will have some small moral and all. At the end of the story, you'll be given some moral of the story. So they also give advice. So many things, so many lessons we covered up from beginning. For you, at least some of the other thing, good things you have learnt, isn't it? You have true friends for night and day. Your friends are very, very true. It may be either night or day. If you have some good books to read. So if you have some good books, even your friendship is also very, very truthful. It will be very, very true. Okay. Again, I will read the poem, page number 87. Name of the poem, Good Books. Good books are friendly things to own. If you are busy, they will wait. They will not call you on the phone or wake you if the hour is late. H-O-U-R. You have to pronounce it. Don't pronounce it as hour. You say R. Or wake you if the hour is late. They stand together row by row upon the low shelf or the high. But if you are lonely, this you know, you have a friend or two nearby. The friendship of books is real. They are never noisy when you are still. They won't disturb you at your meal. They comfort you when you are ill. They'll help you pass the time away. They'll give you advice if you need. You have true friends for night and day if you have some good books to read. So the words are not very, very difficult. It is easy to read also. The words are very, very easy also. So you have to read the textbook. Now, almost you are staying at home. Please don't waste time. As much as possible, utilize it. You go through the textbooks, read line by line. Okay, line by line. And then pronunciation also. Listen to the pronunciation very, very carefully. If it is not clear, you can call and ask me also. Whenever you said a video, you just go through, you just put an ear for anything. You just listen to the pronunciation. And as soon as, if you are not able to understand, mark that line. And then you can call me and ask, what is that word? Surely I will help you. I will guide you to how to pronounce it also. Okay. So what the duty is to open the textbook, read line by line. If you practice all this reading, sing activity and all, you go for the higher classes, it will be easy for you to read the textbooks and all. Otherwise, it will become very, very difficult for you. So what the duty is, open the book and read the poem carefully. Okay. Hope you understood the poem, children. Thank you.